Hello and welcome to the Grand Touring Motorsports Podcast, Break Fix, where we're always fixing to break into something motorsports related.
The Drive-Thru is GTM's monthly news episode and is sponsored in part by organizations like HBDEJunkie.com, Garage Riot, AmericanMuscle.com, Hooked on Driving, and many others. If you're interested in becoming a sponsor of The Drive-Thru, look no further than www.gtmotorsports.org under About and then Advertising and Sponsorship. Thank you again to everyone that supports Grand Touring Motorsports, our podcast Break Fix, and all the other services we provide. The Drive-Thru is our monthly recap where we've put together a menu of local, racing, and random car-adjacent news. Now let's pull up to window number one for some holiday shopping news. This month, we're taking our traditional holiday shopping article and bringing it to you in the form of a podcast.
That's right. It's that time of year again to answer the age-old question. What do you want for the holidays? Most of the time, we've already bought what we needed throughout the season. But your loved ones really want to get you that something. So what do you get for the enthusiast that already has all their toys?
You know, Tanya, it's an extremely difficult thing to do, putting this list together year after year. And it's a tradition here at GTM that we do this. And I tell you what, I think I've been listening to Mariah Carey sing about Christmas since about Halloween. What do you think?
I quickly turn the radio channel off when the Christmas music is playing because it is not past Thanksgiving yet.
And so here we are, if you're listening to this episode on its air date, just after you stuffed yourself with turkey and getting ready for these Black Friday day sales and preparing for holiday shopping, some last minute scramble. So what do you get for the automotive enthusiast that has it all?
Cash, because he's bound to have some broken car part that needs replacing.
There's always that option. That is a great way to start off any holiday shopping guide. Cash, people. Cash. Cash is king.
Cash is king.
Speaking of cash, it wouldn't be a drive-thru episode if we didn't kick off with
rich people doing rich people things.
You didn't say that, right? Rich people doing rich people things.
Doing rich people things. I mean, I think we can just read this headline and then move on. Now there's a licensed 3/4 size Ferrari 250 Testarossa for fancy kids.
How much does this thing sell for? That's what we want to know. It's up there with the Bugatti Baby 2. It's up there with that Aston Martin James Bond thing. What are we talking about price-wise? I'm just curious.
We are talking about for a whopping 37 miles an hour. It is so expensive, they don't list the price in the article.
It's a Ferrari, of course. You only pay for the best.
No.
My baby two's on order.
Is there a baby three? Baby three?
No. What are we talking about? No, this actually is Porsche. But it's actually not really rich people doing rich people things because this is a one-off build that I think is going to go up on auction. So I guess a rich person will buy it, but it is a small size replica of a Porsche 917-30.
That's the Can-Am Porsche Audi blue yellow liveried 917.
No go, correct. And essentially it's a go-kart with the 917 body on it.
I mean, it.
That sounds way better than the Bugatti Baby 2.
And you know what got me about this article? It made me think for a minute, like if you could put a body like this on a go-kart, how cool would it be to have a race that's like a mini IMSA or WEC where you're in a go-kart that looks like a legendary race car? Think about how awesome that would be.
This sounds like the Power Wheels races.
Well, for this, I actually think you're on to something with the go-kart racing of these classic liveried and classic bodied vehicles. And I think if Dr. T and Race are listening to this episode, there's a business model in here that you should tap into. This is an untapped market.
Can you imagine? It'd be bonkers. And I heard a guy talking the other day about how he was going to purchase the option package for his Tesla so that it could sound like a Hemi Challenger while he was going down the road. Apparently they mount these speakers and they can like project the sound so it sounds like something else. And I'm like, you could put that on a go-kart so it doesn't sound like a weed whacker. Can you imagine being like a Ferrari 333 SP replica mini and it sounds like you got a screaming V12? Boom! I mean, mental. I would love this. I'm on board. Sign me up. Ever wonder if you could outrun a police pursuit? This one pulls at my send it button pretty hard.
You won't have to wonder for very long if that police is a Tesla.
Brah.
You or an ID3 or whatever.
Yeah, or any electric vehicle.
But now your wish can come true because in the United Kingdom, you can pay to try.
So wait a second. And the very next subtitle to this article is, it's you and a Porsche Boxster or Mazda Miata versus a law enforcement Dodge Charger. GTFO.
Right? Really? That's what I said.
A Miata versus a Dodge Charger.
On a racetrack. On a highway. Different problem. On a racetrack.
First off-ramp and then Miata would be gone. But here's the deal. Let's give you the bluff, right? The bottom line up front. An hour and a half includes the introductions to the basics, right? So they're assuming people don't have track time, whatever. So they go over safety, racing lines, throttle and braking, you know, typical HPDE and HPDC type of stuff, testing on the track, getting familiar. And then you get to choose between the Boxster or the Miata. I would personally choose the Boxster, knowing what Miatas are like. No offense to Miata lovers, just saying, I'm in a police pursuit. I think I want the Porsche.
Yes.
It's a 15-minute police pursuit. So think about it as a shortened track session, and you're being chased by a Dodge Charger. And your attempt is to escape. Where you're escaping to, I don't know, because you're lapping the track. I feel like I do this on any given weekend at the track anyway, and it probably costs a lot less. But I like the idea of the cherries and berries chasing me around, but not in a Miata. That's for sure. That is for sure. Now, if you had told me, come to the track with your own car and outrun the cops, hell yeah, let's do this. I'm in it to win it.
Yeah, I mean, it seems a little gimmicky. The headline was so cool. I was like, oh, this is going to be awesome. I think it was one of the old Top Gear episodes. Maybe it was Top Gear US, where they had like a military base where they'd abandoned the housing section. And so they ended up doing some little contest where they're running from Stig or Stig's chasing them around the housing section. And so you had this kind of residential setup, but of course there's nobody there. So if you jump a curb or run into a house or something, it's not a big deal. I was hoping it might be something like that. It seems like just a way to play flashlight tag on a racetrack.
Yeah, exactly. And in a Miata, you're not going to get very far in 15 minutes. I hate to break it to you folks, especially with a Hemi Charger behind you. It's not going to work. It's not going to take him very long to catch you. You better have like a 3-minute head start or something. But so if you didn't spend all your money on all these other rich people things, and you're flush with cash, as we said at the beginning of the episode, what can you buy with all that extra do-re-mi?
Well, you've probably never thought about going to LamborghiniStore.com.
Oh?
And honestly, you can get yourself this, lovely is a strong word.
Safety cone yellow. Let's call it what it is.
According to the listing, green soft shell jacket with what I think appears to be reflective striping. So you'll be safe at night. Now it's on sale. So you're getting a steal here at $404.60. Regularly $578. So look at this bargain you're getting. It's almost $200 off.
For a jacket you could buy at Tractor Supply. I do not understand.
Go to REI, get yourself a cycling jacket. It'll be highly reflective. It'll cost a quarter of this.
But it won't say Scuderia Lamborghini Automobili on the back or whatever.
It's okay because you can still get it in this obnoxious green color. Trust me, because I've seen them. But you're right. It will not have the Lamborghini badge on the arm or the Lamborghini wording on the back of the hood.
But you know what that jacket might be useful for? Because I don't think too many Lamborghini owners are going to be riding their bicycles in the dark, especially if they own a Lamborghini.
I was going to take a guess, but continue.
It might make you highly visible at the Miami Grand Prix.
Oh, see, I was going with when your Lamborghini breaks down on the side of the road and you're standing outside of it waiting for AAA, he'll see you.
That's a very good point as well. But if we're searching for you on TV, you would definitely stand out in that Lamborghini jacket at the Miami Grand Prix, right? Or would you?
I don't know, because with 275,000 of your other friends sporting their Lamborghini jackets, I don't think you're going to be seen in the crowd.
275,000 tickets sold for an 80,000 person capacity event. So if you missed out on this inaugural Miami Grand Prix Formula One race, you didn't get your tickets, you're out of luck.
you didn't spend anywhere from $11.90 to $15.50. And I'm not saying $15.50, $1,550 for turn 18 tickets. Not that I know where turn 18 is, quite honestly, but nonetheless, turn one as high as $1,695. Now, if you're on a budget, you could have gotten a beach ticket for $640. Sounds like a deal.
I thought Coda was expensive. This is ridiculous.
I mean, compared to this, shoot, the tickets at Coda were free.
Right. Yeah, that's absolutely true. But yay.
And it came with a concert at Coda. I saw Miss Taylor Swift. Thank you very much.
This is why we're talking about rich people doing rich people things, because this is just, it's insane. I mean, you can go to an SCCA race for free. So, you know, hey, whatever. If you missed your opportunity to go to the Miami Grand Prix, you have still the opportunity to buy tickets for the Goodwood Festival of Speed. They just went on sale at the same weekend as the Petit Le Mans at Road Atlanta, where I was live there with folks from Garage Riot, MIE Racing, and a few others. Festival of Speed is the hill climb. I want to clarify that. There are actually two races at Goodwood. There is the Festival of Speed and the Revival. The Festival of Speed is the hill climb, and the Revival is the track event. The track event tickets are not yet available, and the Festival of Speed is going to be held in June of 22. And you can learn more about Goodwood at www.goodwood.com. So get your tickets today, and I guarantee you could probably buy them for 10 of your other friends for the cost of that Miami Grand Prix ticket. Taxes, tags, airfare, lodging, and other things need not apply to my statement.
I'm thinking, here's the bargain. You buy that Lambo jacket for $404 on sale, and then instead of buying a ticket to the race, just sit in your living room and watch it on TV. Look, you just saved an extra $1,000. Boom.
That's pretty good. You're ahead in that mathematics.
Well, if you're in the market for a luxurious motorhome and you happen to have a cool $2.4 million burning a hole in your pocket, you could check out a German brand called Volkner Mobile that makes a very luxurious motorhome for which you could also slide your Bugatti or other high-performance luxury car underneath in its own private garage.
I love that the second picture is an i8. That's a bit of a change.
I mean,
number one, Bugatti Chiron. Picture number two, an i8 we picked up for $5.
We've seen these before on the old Top Gear, where they showed this being done with a Morgan Aero 8, if I remember correctly, and they had an older Volkner on there. So I'm glad to see that they're still around. Didn't realize there was a huge market for these things. Redefines the toter home and the toy hauler and whatnot. But yeah, if you got $2.4 million to burn, what the hell not? Send it.
I mean, it looks super nice inside. I don't know if it looks $2.4 million nice though.
And maybe if 2.4 is too steep, maybe the stereo system is an option, because that would save you $355,000.
Whoa. Brings it down to a cool $1.9 million. All right. More taxes, tags, and insurance.
Woo.
So like most years, we like to talk about things for your garage. This year was a little bit tougher. We have a huge list of things in our show notes in the category of tools, and we're not going to cover all of them. Some of them are, you know, dead pullers and rivet makers and all sorts of really neat stuff that you can use for working on the car. And so we've listed that in the show notes. Go ahead and check it out. It's pretty extensive, but I did come across something I thought was pretty cool for maybe your office, your den, your man cave,
or even the garage.
That's right. And I found it on all places, Etsy.
Etsy can be a little underrated for car-related things, I think, because surprisingly, there are some interesting things. And sometimes artists will post their work through Etsy, and there's some pretty good car drawing artists. So if you're ever bored, Etsy is an interesting place to find maybe some unique gifts. But this one in particular,
happens to be a set of logoed banners that you can get for different marks. The one in particular that we're listing in the show notes is for Team Corvette Racing. I think it looks really cool. In some ways, it's better than having the team flag because of how long it is and how skinny it is. I could find more places for it, either in my office or in my garage. I like the way it looks. And there's more things like this on Etsy.
Well, this one is like, it's got this Punisher vibe to it, right? Because they put the Corvette flag, you know, Punisher type helmet.
Oh, that's, you don't know about that? That's Jake. No. That's
who?
Jake. That's
Jake from State Farm?
No, that's Jake, Team Corvette mascot. That's been around since the C5R now. So that's a long time logo that Team Corvette has been using. So this is really cool.
Wow. I have not seen that before.
Yeah.
I have been under a rock.
So speaking of Etsy, do you remember our friends from Everything I Learned from Movies, the crossover episode we did earlier this year?
Do you mean Steve and Izzy?
That's right. And here's a quick word from Steve and Izzy.
Hey, everybody. Are you looking for the perfect stocking stuffer for the holidays? Do you like supporting the arts? Well, then you need to check out untidyvenus.etsy.com, the top one-stop shop that always pops her top. Are you a fan of dinosaurs? Snacks? Dinosaurs made out of snacks? Movie monsters? Unicorns? Cats? Dogs? Rats? Shrimp? Pokemon? Tie-dye? Paracord bracelets? Paracord dog leashes? Enamel pins? Coloring books? Block prints? Watercolor? Pet portraits? Buttons? Magnets? Stickers? Bottle openers? Artist trading cards? Or really anything else that's awesome? Then stop on by untidyvenus.etsy.com. That's a goddess who's bad at housekeeping. .etsy.com. New items are popping up all the time, so be sure to follow her on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, or Patreon at untidyvenus. Or visit her website at izzycreates.com for the latest. Did I mention the Snackosaurs? How about Gary the Unicorns? untidyvenus.etsy.com. The goddess who's bad at housekeeping. Check it out now.
All right, and we're back. So let's talk about things for your ride. And if it wouldn't be a drive-through episode if we didn't do some Volkswagen Audi Porsche news, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this little bit of information is brought to us by New German Performance. They've got all sorts of deals on parts from Black Forest Industries,
New Speed,
O34 Motorsports,
APR,
CTS,
and more.
That's right. Both of NGP's locations are stocked with sale items, and you can find it on their website, ngpracing.com. We also put a link specifically to those sale items in the show notes, so check that out on our website. And if you need help getting those parts, those sale parts installed, NGP can set that up for you as well. Also, if you are looking for something in particular that isn't on their list of preferred brands or sale items, be sure to reach out to Mike Humphrey at NGP at mike@ngpracing.com for additional information and assistance with anything you might be looking for your Volkswagen, Audi, or Porsche. You know, we would be remiss if we didn't just find random car adjacent things to talk about in this particular segment. And one of them that got me really scratching my head the other day was when I was searching on Newegg.com and realized they now sell car parts. Did anybody realize that? Is this like the end of Newegg? But then I also came to find out that they quietly went IPO this past week. And so I'm like, huh, that's kind of weird. Yeah, I'm not sure. So maybe Newegg will be the new Advanced Auto or something online and we can order car parts and stuff. I mean, I looked at the catalog. There's an interesting array of things, accessories and stuff to wash your car. And I'm not going to probably buy oil filters from there. But just, you know, if you want to save a buck or two, maybe check out Newegg.com and see if they've got something that you can't actually buy on Amazon.
I will say that they are accepting multiple different currencies, especially Dogecoin. So anybody who's got some Dogecoin lying around.
Is that like Doge? Is that Dogecoin?
Yeah, whatever. Dogecoin. I say Doge because it's a dog. What the fuck is a Doge? Doge.
That's awesome.
So another item for your ride, Track Decals is having a 15% off everything sale. And if you've never been to their website, if you're looking for numbers for your car or you want to tattoo your ride with the latest track you've been to, head on over to trackdecals.com and check out their inventory.
That's right. And they also provide all of the safety stickers and club racing stickers that you'll need for next season. So 15% off goes a long way if you're gearing up or doing a new livery on your vehicle for the 2022 season. So be sure to check out trackdecals.com for everything you need. maybe you've got a Ford, Chevy, or Mopar, and it needs a little bit of TLC this winter, maybe in preparation for the track season. So I'm going to tell you to head on over to our sponsor, AmericanMuscle.com, for all of your performance Ford, Chevy, or Dodge parts and accessories. Check out their wide assortment of replacement parts for your daily driver or high-performance add-ons for your autocross, time attack, weekend warrior. So remember to check out AmericanMuscle.com for details, and we look forward to having them on our show on a future episode. So stay tuned for more on that. Remember, AmericanMuscle.com for all your high-performance domestic parts, accessories, and performance needs. Now, let's talk a little bit about gifts for you. Let's be a little bit selfish.
Let's. And as we hopefully put COVID in the rearview mirror, be able to get out more, travel, get on airplanes again, trains, planes, automobiles, whatever your flavor is. You know, when you're doing that, you need to store your stuff in something, right? What do we normally use?
We use luggage, travel bags, roll-ons, carry-ons.
All of the above. And who do you usually think about? You usually think of
JanSport. I'm thinking JanSport.
JanSport backpacks. No, Samsonite was what I was thinking of for luggage, for the roller bags and things like that. You don't normally think of Sparco. Exactly. You do think of them for helmet bags or, you know, other car booties, accessories, seats,
little booties,
sweatshirts like you're wearing right now. But they have a line of travel bags. So not just backpacks, but also duffels and carry-on luggage for airplanes.
I really like these. There's some cool styles in there, especially their new Martini Racing livery-inspired apparel and accessories they have, like this luggage. I think it looks super cool. Obviously, that's a throwback to the Martini Lanchas and Porsches and things like that. But I also like the fact that some of the bigger bags, if you're not traveling on a plane, have a compartment for your helmet along with your clothes. I kind of wish I knew about that before I bought my track luggage that I have. I mean, I went with Swiss Army. It is what it is. But had I known these existed, I could do a two-in-one helmet and clothes together. Talk about amazing. And they look stellar. I mean, even their basic black, I like the way it's stitched together, the way it looks. Just there's that flair to it. It's a Sparco thing, you know?
And you might be rolling your eyes going, oh, that's nice. Sparco, huh? How much do those cost? Like a Lamborghini coat? But actually, these are actually on par with standard luggage prices. I mean, $179 for a carry-on roller bag, that's really not astronomical or out of the range of something you walk into Macy's and go to the luggage section and see.
Exactly. And with, you know, Sparco quality, I've had a lot of Sparco gear over the years. It holds up really, really well. And their warranties are really good. Plus, you could look for items like this through our sponsor, OG Racing. So if you want, reach out to Mark at OGRacing.com and inquire about the Sparco bags, or reach out to us as well and find out what the pricing might be like on some of these Sparco accessories. And remember, more than just bags, it's apparel, it's shoes, it's gloves, helmets, you name it, steering wheels, seats. I mean, they've been making motorsports related gear for a very long time. You remember a while back, we talked about the Mach-E 1400. Do you guys recall that?
Yes.
So Ford put out that monster super drift car equivalent to 1400 horsepower. It's a Ford Performance factory only vehicle. They've got some factory drivers, you know, doing all these videos and whatnot. So to give you a taste, quote unquote, of what the experience is like in the Mach-E 1400, they have partnered with Hot Ones to create the Mach-E hot sauce. And so we posted the video of this as Ford factory driver and the host of Hot Ones sit down together and kind of go back and forth. It's an interesting kind of fun little 2-minute video showcasing the Mach-E and this hot sauce, which probably tastes like liquid fire, as far as I can tell. I mean, they're near tears in the video as they're eating these chicken wings, and they keep pouring the sauce on there. And it's pretty brutal looking. I don't know. Get yourself some Mach-E 1400 hot sauce. That's all I'm going to say. Well, since we're talking about ways to blow your money, two things came across my desk this month. I found some really cool logoed merch, officially licensed products at paddockcollectionstore.com. So if you're looking for stuff from F1 teams, Brumos Porsche, IMSA related stuff, pretty much different facets of the motorsport world, check out paddockcollectionstore.com for some actually great sales, reasonably priced, officially licensed merchandise. And on top of that, I saw an ad on Instagram for something called the Block Zone, which is the coolest custom Lego sets I have ever seen. So there's a group in the UK that puts together and sells sports cars, race cars, etc., for you to buy. You know, they're not Lego sets, they are the Block Zone sets, although they are comprised of Legos. You can order these reasonably priced. What's funny is if you want to search for certain brands like Porsche or Lamborghini or Ferrari, you have to use kind of creative ways to look them up, like the old bull is what they call the Countach, and the prancing horse is Ferrari. But you learn their nomenclature pretty quickly, and there's some very cool sets out there. I highly recommend the Porsche 917 kit. Came in right around 150 pounds or so, which, you know, can be kind of expensive, but it's a 2000 piece set and it looks really, really good. So check that out. We'll post the link for it in the show notes and maybe think about that as a Christmas gift for your petrol head this winter. Well, it wouldn't be the holidays
if you didn't have an ugly Christmas sweater party to go to.
Oh God, that's become such a thing now.
You know, I've never had an ugly Christmas sweater, and I felt in the spirit this year, but instead of getting an ugly Christmas sweater, I opted for an ugly Christmas t-shirt.
I have one of those too. It's pretty heinous.
Although mine isn't. It's quite cute. Shall be debuted later this year.
So according to AutoWeek, there are now car-themed holiday sweaters?
Yes, this is true. And they are the vibe of the ugly Christmas sweater pattern and design, but car themed. And, you know, they're pretty nice, actually. I like the Drifting Through the Snow Lambo or GTR. And there's another one with an old Mustang on it. They've got Winter Turbo. They've got for Rotary Friends.
I like the Bronco one. I mean, it reminds me of the Denver
at first.
Football team, but I'm like, I kind of like that one. I like the one with the tow trucks. I mean, they're all pretty cool.
They've got what, Mercedes, Porsche with a Christmas tree on top.
Those look a little Rad Racer to me, a little Sega Outrun. I mean,
that's fine. That's fine.
That rotary one's pretty cool though. So these are really neat. They're something to check out. Price-wise, you're sitting at
$34.99.
Yeah, $32, somewhere anywhere between $29 and $35, looks like. And some of these are directly available on Amazon.com. So we have a link to this in our show notes as well. And so if you're looking for something fun for your petrol heads soon to be attending ugly sweater party, this is a way to go.
Indeed.
Now, one of my favorite gifts as a kid was model cars. I still have a large collection of model cars. I specifically have always been a big fan of 1/18th scale cars, which are becoming harder and harder to find anymore, especially in high quality. Now, there are brands like Auto Art out there and others that came on the scene, you know, already a decade ago at this point, compared to the classic days of like the Burrigo and the Maisto and those types of cheaper brands that are still out there and still available. But I always get this boyish grin on my face anytime I see a new way to get a 1/18th scale car. And so again, from Auto Week, just like the collection of sweaters, there's a collection of model cars for us petrol heads of a certain age. What do we think?
I mean, this is an interesting collection. I guess this is just a snippet of their collection. I mean, it ranges from everything from the Bugatti Chiron to a 62 VW bus to a Ford Velociraptor. So I think you could find anything for that car enthusiast in your life. A 1934 Duesenberg 2SJ.
That's actually not bad looking. I mean, the sizes are a little bit over the map in their collection here, ranging from 1/24th scale to 1/18th scale. So 1/24th scale is going to be about 6.5 inches versus a 1/18th scale is 9 to 10 inches, depending on the car. But I did chuckle a little bit. The bottom right-hand corner, there is a, what is that, Tanya? What does it say there?
A 1/8 Porsche R8. Le Mans.
Yeah, and what's the picture of?
Not a Porsche.
Yeah, that's the privateer champion Audi R8, you know, after the crocodile car of Alan McNish, who, by the way, I just happened to see at Road Atlanta not long ago.
Now, the real question is, did you click on the Audi R8 and see how much it costs? Because this is a rich people doing rich people thing.
Yeah, it has the whopping price tag on.
Well, for 4 interest-free installments of $2,912.50, it could be yours, or one-time payment of $11,650. Taxes and shipping not included.
It's cool, but for that price, I think I'd rather buy a real car off of racingjunk.com. And that's another thing. If you haven't heard of racingjunk.com and you're listening to this, go check them out for some ideas for your petrol head as well. Maybe you can find a spare engine or something on there if that's what they're looking for. But, you know, on the cheaper side of things, I came across a new brand of model car that I didn't know about. And so there's a company called Solido. They're based out of France. And they only sell through dealerships, which I think is kind of interesting. And their catalog skews quite European and very French in some cases. And there's a US dealer in Georgia. And I don't know if the dealer I bought from at the Petite, you know, happens to be on their list, but I did pick up a Solido 1/18th scale Momo 935 while I was there. And I tell you what, the quality was really good and it was inexpensive. It was under $70 for a 1/18th scale model. Now, retrospectively, I'm like, oh my God, $70. That's a lot. By today's standards, it's actually quite cheap. A lot of these diecast models have gone really up in price. And when you compare it to like an Auto Art where they clock in at nearly $200 each, it's a steal. It's a bargain, right? It doesn't have full suspension and things like that, like you come accustomed to on some of the higher end ones, but to put on my desk to go, ooh, I got a Momo 935. It's pretty cool. And it gets your attention, you know, from 10 feet away.
Oh, it's very nice. I mean, I haven't seen it in person yet, but in photo seems nice.
So speaking of other things that you can get for yourself, I don't know how many times I've been getting ready for a presentation and someone has leaned over to me in a conference room and said, isn't that the GTI Plaid? Or where did you get those socks? Because let's face it, socks are the new tie. Portugal-based Heel Tread is a unique brand of socks that draws its inspiration from motorsports and aircraft. Their collection pays tribute to some of the world's most renowned automotive icons. We get to wear our passion. We get to take it out there on the streets and show people, hey, check out this cool design. Or you get that question. What is that? What are you wearing exactly? Where did you get that? Well, I got it over at Heel Tread and you definitely got to check it out. So with that in mind, any shout outs, promotions, special discounts, anything you want to tell the world about coming up here in our holiday season?
Yeah, we actually are going to have a big Black Friday promotion as everyone does. It's going to start at the end of November. So you can subscribe to our newsletter and be the first to get that information. And a lot of cool things coming up until the end of the year. We are launching also sport socks and knee-high socks. You can wear them to when you go to the gym or to do whatever you want. Or if you are a guy who needs high socks because you have cold in the winter.
Are these sport socks going to be thicker?
Yeah, thick socks. Yeah, crew socks, like the American-style socks. We are going to launch a small collection to test it. And it's going to be mid-October. I think they're going to be available on the promotion for Black Friday also.
I know exactly what I'm ordering.
Yeah, good. There's always a 10% discount on your first order. So you can test the brand and see if you like the socks. If you don't like the socks, you just can return them. There's no problem there. You subscribe to our newsletter. You will receive then a confirmation and a discount code for your first order of 10% off. Yeah, I have a special discount code for all the fans of BreakFix. It's BreakFix2021. So you just put the code on checkout on the checkout and you'll get 20% off.
That's but awesome.
It's not, cumulative with other promotions. So when we run the Black Friday promotion, you cannot use it. Sorry.
Okay. Good to know. But we very much appreciate that. So if you haven't ordered Heel Tread socks yet, this is your opportunity to get in on that and check out the designs and really show off your motorsports pride and your enthusiasm about different brands or things that you really geek out upon. So 20% off. Thank you very much, Gonzalo. That's very, very generous. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Designed and produced in Portugal, Heel Tread uses seamless toe knitting to create a sock without any stitches. 80% combined cotton, 17% polyamide, and 3% elastane. Every sock is beautiful inside and out. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to drop Gonzalo a line at info@heeltread.com or follow them on social media at Heel Tread. That's HEELTREAD. And more importantly, if you have an idea for a new design or want to create the perfect gift, send them an email with a design or inspiration you'd like them to work with at design@heeltread.com. And if you're thinking about other things for yourself, each box contains hand-picked items, including tools, wearables, garage gear, detailing supplies, magazines, collectibles, and coupons. Whoa, what are we talking about, you ask? Tonight, we're joined by John Sayer from Petrol Box to discuss why this Petrolhead curated monthly box is something you'll be anxiously anticipating. What are the tiers? What do you get in the different tiers? And what do they cost?
So we have our Petrol Box Basic, which is typically 2 to 3 items each month, starting at $19.95 a month. Then we have our Petrol Box Premium, which is typically 5 to 7 items. Some of the bigger, heavier items in this box starting at $39.95 a month. And depending on how long you subscribe, it does get a little bit cheaper as well.
So there's 2 tiers. And obviously, it's probably cheaper if you buy the whole year up front than going monthly as well, right?
Correct. Yeah. If you bought 12 months for the subscription, you're basically getting like 2 months free.
You know, like a lot of other companies that do this, there's usually sister brands or other things that people aren't aware of. So is there anything else that Petrol Box or that you're involved in that you'd want to let people know about?
So recently, just this year, we did start our dog accessory brand. It's called Petrol Pup. Petrol Pup is a thing I've been working on for a while. I have probably the cutest dog in the world, and he just needed some more space to shine. So we got him his own little brand of car enthusiasts, motorsports inspired dog collars and leashes. And right now we have about 7 different designs because my dog loves going to the car shows and all the attention he gets. So we just get him looking good for the car shows.
Doggy bandanas are big to do. We actually have them available on our store site as well with our logos on them. And a lot of our members, you know, put them on their dogs. And obviously they switch them up. It's like wearing t-shirts, right? Well, this time I'm going to wear Formula One bandana. Next week I'm going to wear Petrol Beds bandana or whatever. So, you know, it all works. But so you're talking about the subscription, all that. So that being said, you know, with us looking at the holiday season, you know, it's very fast approaching. Any shout outs, promotions, special discounts, anything you want to throw out there? You want to let people know about?
Yeah, absolutely. One of the best coupon codes we have out there is 2021. You'll get 21% off your entire first order from Petrol Box. So you'll get that first month's box for 21% off.
That's a really solid deal. And that's good through the end of the calendar year through 2021?
Correct.
Oh, that's awesome. Check that out, listeners. Get 21% off your subscription of Petrol Box starting now in the holidays through the end of the year. That's really, really cool. To get the best in automotive swag and goodies, you definitely have to check out Petrol Box. Hop on over to
mypetrolbox.com
and see the previous month's collections and sign up today, especially using that coupon code 2021 to get 21% off your subscription, or follow them on social at petrol.box. In addition to that, you know, thinking about yourself, gearing up for next season, maybe it's time to refresh your safety gear. Personally, I go through a set of gloves almost annually. If I'm lucky, I get 2 years out of them before I basically destroyed them. One of the first things to go, shoes is the next, especially if you're wearing driving shoes around the paddock and you're not switching in and out. You know, you could consider the normal brands, right? The Race Quips and the Sparkos and all these different ones. But how about checking out our friend and GTM member, John Cafisi's Project Motoring line of safety gear. He's SFI certified. He's got some really cool designs and some techniques on personalizing your safety gear, your driving suits, your shoes, your gloves, etc. to match your style, match the livery of your car. And we're actually going to be airing an episode where he explains how this all came about, the process he's undergone, and what he offers coming up here really soon. So pay attention to Break Fix 2 weeks from now, where you can learn more about Project Motoring, abbreviated PMX, and their line of safety gear and safety equipment.
Since you have your ugly Christmas sweater and you're going to your now ugly Christmas car themed sweater party, you need some activities to do at that party. Why not some board games?
Are you talking about Settlers of Catan?
No. Well, I mean, that's always a crowd favorite generally.
Ticket to Ride?
Ooh, I love me some Ticket to Ride. I might have just picked up Monopoly. Haven't played in a hot minute. You lose friends playing Monopoly. But always risk, a solid choice as well.
And risk is always a favorite, especially if you've seen the Seinfeld episode and Newman and Kramer, and they're going through the subway and they don't want to mess up the board. Fantastic stuff right there.
If your ugly Christmas car themed sweater party is a week long, then yes, risk would be a viable option. However, I'm thinking more car related.
Okay.
War games. And if you happen to be in Tarjay anytime soon, they have a game called Downforce.
Whoa, what?
And I actually believe you might have this game, a previous version. So this is a redesigned version of basically a car racing game. The highlights, tires screech, gear shift, drivers push their $1 million cars to the limit. The difference between victory and defeat could be a single card. So essentially, you put out this game board that looks like some sort of street course, right? And then everyone has little cars, and you roll dice and you pull cards out of the deck, and you move your race car along predetermined slots on this game board, and you're trying to get to the corner, apex the corner correctly, come out at the right speed. It's all about like the number on your die that you roll and all this stuff to, you know, get to the finish line. At any rate, it's car related.
I got two questions. One, does the car look like the little car from the Game of Life, and can I put little peg people in it? And two, maybe not a question, more of a statement, sounds wholly more exciting than all of last season's Formula One. I'm just going to lay it out there. Okay.
They are Formula One style cars.
Okay. Well, that makes it that much better. I might not fall asleep while I play this game.
Well, if you don't like that one, you might want to check out this next one, which you'd want to play while wearing your Lamborghini jacket.
The high-vis one?
The high-vis Lamborghini jacket. This also, from Tarjay, hey, is a game called Lamborghini, the official race game board. The true listing is Lamborghini, the official race game board game.
That's too many words. It doesn't make sense.
It's a race game that's a board game.
Okay.
Whatever. At any rate, this one, the Lamborghini official board game, is a fascinating economic management of a racing Lamborghini team. Sign the best driver, buy your car and its components, and equip it at your best to face the qualification session. Then drive your Lamborghini Murcielago at 350 kilometers an hour on the Monza or Hockenheim straights. The game is both managing and racing. The five miniatures in the box, scale 1/87, are also a toy for adults and kids. Lamborghini is the official board game, which will drive the sports car fans mad.
So it comes with micro machines. You have to wear a high-vis jacket. And this sounds exactly like, if you remember Parks and Recs, when they brought in the teachers from the rec center and the guy was showing people how to use Quicken. This is exactly like that. Like, this is how to be an accountant as a board game. Now, I'm not deterring anyone from trying it out or checking it out or adding it to their collection. It is officially licensed Lamborghini merchandise. But, you know, hey, whatever. Take it with a grain of salt.
It could be the next best game and we just don't know it.
And there's one more thing we got to talk about, which is, you know, right out in left field.
The Ford Mach-E fragrance.
Is that ode to toilet? I mean, toilet?
sorry, I just got a whiff.
Okay, hold on. So Ford Mach-E fragrance. So the Mach-E is an electric car, right?
Yep.
I know this. I'm just, you know, being that way with my
question. It's rhetorical. I get it. Yeah.
No, and it's good that you answered. Who here has played with a train set?
I know where she's going with this.
Electric train set. Who remembers that smell, that taste almost that gets in your mouth.
It's called ozone.
That smell. That can't you taste. Smell that smell?
Right? Like, even I guess if you went to an electric go-kart track, it'd be the same thing. So is that what this smells like?
Oh, no. No, no. As I read the article, it says the Mach O, okay, spelled E-A-U.
What? That's
the name of the fragrance.
Yes, that's French.
Like many French references we made on this episode this time. It is designed to please the nose of any wearer. A high-end fragrance that fuses smoky accords, aspects of rubber, and even an animal element to give a nod to the Mustang heritage.
What are we talking about?
So it smells like a horse stall because the Mach-E is a Mustang.
That's exactly what I was thinking. It smells like horse shit, and this is a pile of marketing horse shit. This
I like that you said stall because I thought you were going to say horse's ass.
Yeah, but I have class.
Whatever. This is right up there with the whole Mach-E 1400, what is it, red chili Tabasco sauce that came out with like 2 months ago.
So instead of like, can't even remember who the fragrance models are, you know, when they walk down and they do their little thing for like Dior or whatever, who is going to be the spokesperson, the spokesmodel for this? Is it going to be
Ken Block?
Sorry.
No, that would be good.
Let me do it again. I'll get it. Shit, I'm gonna get it. Hold on.
This has gotta be really good.
Is it going to be Mr. Ed? Because it is a Mustang. He's a horse. Of course. Oh. That might be a little too old for some of our listeners.
It might be right in their wheelhouse too. Y'all get New Balances for Christmas. This memorabilia, collectibles, and automobilista, as we call it, over on Garage Riot has been brought to you by the friendly folks at Garage Riot, where we talk about this stuff a lot in a specific channel over there. But here's a couple of words from Donovan about the new platform that's coming out.
Yeah, that's right. So Garage Riot is moving platforms. So Eric's been helping out a lot with that, doing a lot of the work there. So we've been working pretty closely together, but pretty excited to announce that we're moving, sort of. We're definitely changing platforms. Our old one's been around for 5 years. It's served us well, but we're excited some of the new features coming and some new stability in the platform. So if you haven't already, you can visit the new platform. There's links on the current.com site. We hope to have everything built out and switched over officially sometime in November. So look forward to seeing you all online.
That's right. And there's a new phone app coming out as well, right? So we should be looking for some big changes.
That's right. Yeah, those will replace your existing apps. Should just be a regular update from the app stores. So yeah, looking forward to it.
So to add to that, here's a couple of highlights from things that we talked about on Garage Riot. Donovan and I bought a bunch of stuff from Tuned in Tokyo. It is definitely geared towards the JDM crowd. However, the gear is really cool. Original designs, lots of things throwing back to, you know, again, petrolheads of a certain age. If you were a fan of Initial D, a lot of Mount Akina stuff, a lot of, you know, Toyota specific, Nissan specific, et cetera. Really cool gear on the site. I have a sweatshirt that I bought from them. And even my wife went, "Where'd you get that? That's really neat. I like the way that looks." It's actually a lined sweatshirt, so it's double thick. I love wearing it on cold days like today, where you're out and about running around and you don't want to throw on a jacket. So a lot of cool stuff over on tunedintokyo.com. On top of that, I also happened to pick up a pair of shoes based on an article that somebody posted on Garage Riot, and they came from hardtunedstore.com. They're listed as at hardtunedstore or at HGXJPN on Instagram. And what did I buy? I bought the infamous Fujiwara Tofu Shop Hachiroku AE86 Converse Chucks. They are amazing shoes. I love them. I posted about them on Instagram. They're very classy looking and they definitely get people's attention if they're petrol heads. Most people are like, "Oh, you're wearing these like black and white panda Chucks. What are these?" I love them. I like shoes like that. I like things that are neat and get people's attention and get us talking about things, especially from when we were kids.
And don't forget another apparel retailer, Blipshift, usually around this time of the year, or at least heading towards the Christmas holiday season, they start pulling out old designs kind of from the archive, from the vault. And so designs you might have missed earlier in the year, even in the past, start coming back available. So if there was something you missed, go to blipshift.com and don't forget to check out what they've got.
some really cool stuff over there recently. Some Sauber C9 Mercedes, some Corrado, some IMSA Jaguar V12, which actually we saw that car in person at Watkins Glen and got to speak with Mike over at Havoc Performance about it. Sneak peek, there's an episode with Mike coming. So if you want to catch up on some of these designs from this year over to BlipShift, definitely check it out. BlipShift.com for all of your petrolhead teas. Let's talk about other brands, sister brands to Heeltread that people might not know about. I was digging around and I noticed on the website recently there's curatorsocks.com. What's that all about?
Actually, Curator, our office manager, Madalena, she's a big art fan. And what we rebranded our company to be a company that caters to passions. So her biggest passion is art. So we did a sock brand inspired by all the famous artworks. And we launched in February last year. And it worked out really, really well. Not as good as Heeltread. I think the petrolheads are more possessive on that way than art guys. And in July last year, me and João are also big music fans. We launched Stereo Socks. It's inspired by the coolest album covers. It doesn't mean to be the album that sells more records or most famous, but we do socks inspired on the coolest
like Depeche album Mode's covers. Like Depeche Mode's Violator album, right? That would make exactly sense as a sock. Beautiful. Right?
Yeah. Well, it's really, really cool. It's a black sock with only the flower, and we did it in a really special way. That was really cool.
Exactly. And I showed my wife the Curator socks because that's more her style. And she was like, I didn't know they did this. And I'm like, yeah, I think you need to order some, or at least I know what I'm getting her for Christmas this year. That's for sure.
Yeah.
Another thing we talk about at Garage Riot is watches. Donovan is a huge watch collector. I nerd out on them, but I'm super specific. Last year, we talked about the DeLorean watch, the DMC watches by Charlie Foxtrot in the UK. By the way, folks, those are no longer available. So they were available for about an entire year, and now they have been pulled. So if you got one, good on you. I love mine. Couldn't recommend it enough. But we keep an eye on motorsports-inspired watches. There's every once in a while, there's like a golf liveried something or other, you know, by Tag Heuer or Breitlinger or something like that. And then Donovan and I were even joking recently about how there's now Chevy and Ford sports watches and things like that. But there's always those classic Porsche ones, right?
Sure.
And so recently, PCA has put a bunch of different articles right in time for the holidays talking about new watches that are Porsche inspired or designed specifically for Porsche owners or Porsche enthusiasts. So there's a 901/993 exoskeleton called the Chelsea. There's a Porsche designed sport chronograph, which looks like the clock from the latest 991s and 992s modeled after the clock that's in the car. And then they have some Legends Reborn series, things like that. So there's some really cool watches. Maybe on the line of rich people doing rich people things in terms of price compared to, you know, some of the other watches that are out there. But do a search online for motorsport inspired watches. That's a search that I generally use, and you'll be fascinated to see what you come up with. But we've linked to all the ones that we've talked about here in our show notes. So check them out if you're interested.
They're so expensive. The price isn't even listed here. I don't even know. Like, you must have to like knock on a door and say the secret passcode to see what the price is.
I mean, that's like some of those Ferrari kits and Bugatti Baby 2s, and you don't want to know what the price is. Maybe it's free.
I don't. I'm good. Something that could be perhaps more in the price range walletability of listeners is don't forget to go to the Lego shop. So in the recent years, they've created a set theme known as Speed Champions. And so it seems about every year at least, or even multiple times a year, they're kind of coming out with a new vehicle in their lineup. I mean, they've got the Rally Audi Sport Quattro, they've got 1974 911, they've got trucks, they've got Mercedes and other Ferraris, small size and also large size. So there's also a 74 911 that's
1/8 scale. Yeah.
So don't forget to check that out if you want a fun toy, maybe, you know, for yourself or for the kids in your life.
That's
or
right,
yourself.
Man. And going back to what you said about earlier about Jake from Team Corvette, there's even some C8R as well as Bronco kits now. So they are on the front end of new models that are coming out. So don't, you know, Legos aren't just for kids, like you said, for yourself. I know that there's a bunch of us in GTM and even over at Garage Ride that love putting some of these bigger kits together, some of these 1/8 scale Bugattis and Porsches, Lamborghinis and things that have come out. So keep an eye on them. And the other thing I'll say about Legos is, don't wait. Grab it now. If you see it, usually it's low production runs, especially on the car-based stuff, and the prices go through the roof if you try to get them later from a collector. If you see it now, grab it now, especially places like Walmart and Target. And don't forget, stocking stuffers, Hot Wheels, and Matchbox always go a long way. It's a great way to spend 94 cents. If you're looking for something else, maybe for yourself or for someone else, a loved one, let's rewind the clock a little bit and go back to our crossover episode with John W. Warner IV, author of the Little Anton series. And as a reminder, his new book, Lion, Tiger, Bear, just released and is available on Amazon. You know, if you're not turning wrenches over the winter and you've got a voracious reader at home, or you are one yourself and you want to add something to your collection, pick up Lion, Tiger, Bear, or the entire Little Anton series, as it is, quote unquote, car adjacent, but I don't want to spoil it for you. Go back and check out the episode we did called Beyond Little Anton with John W. Warner IV, and it explains everything about the series. And oh, by the way, there's a bonus episode on Patreon that will release probably later in 22 that you can get a head start on Lion, Tiger, Bear and get a little bit behind the scenes on some aliens too. So in the spirit of giving, we want to highlight a couple quick things. Obviously, there's different organizations out there that are keeping track of events in a sort of non-denominational way, we'll call it that. And one of them is always Garage Riot. And right now, you know, obviously the tail end of the year is upon us and a lot of things are winding down. But posted on Garage Riot's site, I noticed that there is a charity 5K going on at National Corvette Museum.
I noticed that as well because I get NCM emails.
That's true. So, but they call it the Run Rudolph 5K, and it'll be happening on December 11th at 5 p.m. at the National Corvette Museum track. So if you live in the Bowling Green area and want to give back to the community in a motorsport sort of way, it's a great opportunity to get out there. In addition to that, a little bit of a sneak peek on an upcoming partnership and episode that we're doing. The Collector Car Guide is also your source for events and recommended vendors. They're kind of new on the scene within the last year to 18 months. They have a paper publication that they put out, but also their website is very comprehensive. And you can look at events throughout the East Coast in the motorsports community, from car shows to track events to others. And so they are also listing some charity events and festivals and car shows here for the late fall and early winter. So check out collectorcarguide.com. Before we get into some shout outs and close out the episode,
wouldn't be a drive through episode unless we went down south to our southern neighbors.
We talking holiday Florida man stories?
Holiday Florida man stories. And yes, folks, the holidays have not happened yet, so we do not have fresh out of the oven holiday stories of 2021 for you. So we are going to go back in time to last year when you would have thought, thanks to COVID lockdowns, there wasn't really much holiday getting together, not in Florida.
hold on. I got to add more rum to my eggnog before we get into this.
We'll go reverse because Thanksgiving at the time of this recording is a mere 2 days away. So we'll start Christmas time and then we'll work our way back to Thanksgiving. So headline alone, like to start with those because they're always good. Florida woman charged with assaulting sister with a Christmas decoration.
Wait, what?
And I got really excited because I'm thinking there's lots of kinds of Christmas decorations here. Are we talking about, like, you know, the big pieces outside, outdoor decorations?
Rudolph's getting the beat down.
I was a little disappointed when it's merely a beaded cone tree. So I guess it's like a Christmas cone, like a little mini Christmas tree that's shaped like a like an ice cream cone. It's a stabbing device, and she stabbed essentially her sister in the left side of the torso with the Christmas cone due to some sort of altercation that they had. And there was that, but then further kind of reading through the article, apparently there was another incident in Florida. Fights at Christmas time, using Christmas decorations is a big thing. This one's even better, I think. They said a similar incident. And similar in that it's a Christmas decoration, but this is the kind of decoration I was looking for. Florida woman hit her boyfriend with sections of her family's artificial Christmas tree.
with sections of the Christmas tree.
The woman's last name is Graham, told the police the couple began arguing because her boyfriend had set, quote, the TV volume on too high while she was sleeping. In response, she had, quote, squared up to the victim and was screaming in his face. She admitted to the police that she, quote, took apart an artificial Christmas tree and threw three sections of the tree at the victim.
I mean, apparently in Florida, you could weaponize anything. Wow.
I mean, that takes, you had nothing else to go for? I mean Christmas tree.
What was that guy doing while she's disassembling the Christmas? Or was it like rapid fire, like the Tasmanian devil? Like, was he just standing here and he's watching her like take apart the Christmas tree and then he gets chucked in his face? I mean, how much of a dunce can you be?
I don't know, because I mean, regardless of a pre-lit tree or not, I'm going to go out on a limb. You have lights strung around it. And if they're not pre-lit, well, even if they are, you got to disconnect the strands. If not, the whole tree is still like kind of together by virtue of the lights. And then you got the balls flying everywhere or whatever other hanging ornaments you have. I mean, what was that dude doing?
He was, maybe, I don't understand. Please, folks, don't let your Christmas turn into this disaster. That's for sure.
Please don't get a misdemeanor jail time on your record for throwing Christmas tree parts at your boyfriend or girlfriend.
I mean,
or
how does that 911 call go? Excuse me, operator. I've been assaulted by a Christmas tree. Like, seriously? Like, I don't understand.
Oh, who did it, Santa?
Right? I mean, how do they even keep a straight face?
Were you naughty this year?
It's ridiculous.
Oh, God. Oh. But here we go. Also saving the best for last. Let's move to Thanksgiving. You don't even need to read the rest of the article. There's not even anything else to the article, okay? Honestly, because it's summed up in its entirety by the title. Florida man defrosts Thanksgiving turkey in swimming pool.
What?
Y'all be worried about, oh, snap, I haven't taken my turkey out of the freezer yet. Thanksgiving's in 2 days. How will it ever defrost? No. You got a swimming pool in Florida? Throw that sucker in there. It takes just a few hours, apparently.
So does the salmonella. Only takes a couple hours, too. I mean,
add that little extra something-something.
Oh, God. Really? I mean, in the hot tub, but then you'd end up cooking it, right?
Quote, we thaw our turkey in the pool. That's how you do it when you live in Florida. I didn't know that. I've never lived in Florida.
I mean, we learn something new every month.
Every year, a different family member throws the turkey into the pool.
I mean, that's tradition. I mean, that's almost a slam dunk. Throw it in.
Most people wonder, doesn't the chlorine get into your turkey?
That's a little extra. That just keeps it moist.
He says, these bags are sealed by the factories. We've never had a leakage yet, and no chlorine is in our turkey. All right.
I mean, then it's like a sous vide at that point, right? So, I mean, I get it.
I mean, those turkey bags are pretty thick, but...
So is the skull of the person doing this. But, you know, hey, whatever.
And please, people, before you get any ideas, the United States Department of Agriculture does recommend that there are three ways to safely thaw your turkey. One, in the refrigerator, two, in cold water, or three, apparently in the microwave. That sounds like a lot of work.
What? All right. Well, thank goodness I don't like turkey. Well, now that we've spread a little holiday cheer, it's time for us to wrap out with some local news and some shout outs. So first, let's kick off with Mike Arrigo from Hooked on Driving.
We do two promotions at the end of the year and the beginning of the year. So basically, right before Christmas, we have our frequent driver program that comes out. So you're going to be able to buy a gift certificate that never expires. You're basically saving somewhere in that 10% range. David Ray puts it out every year, but come right around December, we send an email out to everybody, you know, the frequent driver program's on. And then at the beginning of the year, they do it also. So in January, right after the new year starts. So for people that are balancing budgets and different businesses from, you know, 1 year to next year, have two opportunities to kind of grab those out there. And like I said, they never expire. They're good for everything we do out there, except for the private coaching that we provide. So that gift certificate is good for anything out there. The one thing people need to know is, like, the gift certificates are regional. You can't buy a gift certificate and say, I'm going to use it in, you know, a New York track and then a California track and then head down to Texas. So they are regional for your region. And that's why there's two levels. You know, our sponsorship packages are going to be coming out soon again that go out to everybody out there for our, you know, regional sponsors for the year, like you see up on our website and some of the people I've talked about that do stuff for out there. So I know there's a lot of people out there with businesses, and, you know, our sponsored packages are very flexible out there for people. So it could be anything from a yearly sponsorship, you know, where you're, you know, you're a title sponsor and you're on our website, to something that's more localized and regional, where, you know, you might have something at a certain track and say, you know, that's a title sponsor for that event. And, you know, lunch has been provided by, you know, ABC dealership or anything like that. So we're very adaptive in what people need and want to do like that.
And to continue our HPDEJunkie.com trackside update, all these trackside news brought to you by our friend Dave Peters over at HPDEJunkie.com. He is underway in terms of updating the track day schedule for 2022. And guess what? Our friend Nabil sent us his 2022 schedule already, and we haven't even finished the year yet. And that means Dave is going to have it up on his site. Let's review really quickly. Starting in January, they're kicking off at Barber Motorsports Park, then headed to AMP, Roebling Road, Road Atlanta, Atlanta Motorsports Park again, and so on down the line. They're going to be at Carolina again in August. We hope to join them there, maybe at some of these other events, but they've got a full schedule from January through December. I'm looking at 15 events. That's awesome. So Nabil also gives an exclusive little sneak peek here on the 2022 schedule. He is offering an off-season rate for the Barber event in January. That would make a great Christmas gift for a lot of people if they live in the Southeast or are looking to check a bucket list track off their list. So you can get a special discount with Just Track It at their January 15, 16 Barber Motorsports Park event.
Beautiful track.
It is an absolutely beautiful track. And remember to check out the full-length episode that we did with Nabil from Just Track It earlier this season to learn all about their program if you're hearing about them for the first time. Again, stay tuned for updates on their registration, and their events will all open up shortly on clubregistration.net. So if you're from the East Coast and you're used to using Motorsport Reg, they use a different platform that's prevalent in the South known as clubregistration.net. So be sure to check out their events there or check out their website, justtrackit.net. And also be sure to go to hpdjunkie.com as your source for track days across North America.
Chin has also already posted their track list for next year. So go to chintrackdays.com to check out their list. And please note something very exciting that I picked up on as I perused their list as soon as I got their email. May 14th and 15th, 2022, Saturday and Sunday, Chin breaks the ice at a brand new track.
Ooh.
Ozarks International Raceway, OIR.
I'm excited. How far is that?
Far.
Where is it?
It is in Gravois Mills, Missouri.
Ooh.
Which, if you're from, let's say, the Washington, D.C. area, that is a mere 15-hour.
Oh, is that all?
15, 16-hour drive, approximately 995 miles, depending on route. Basically, get on 70 and just keep driving till you make a left to OIR.
That would be our longest cannonball yet. But for our members in the middle and west region, region five, that, you know, are based out of Bowling Green, based out of Michigan and Ohio and other places, it's not that far of a stretch for them to get there. Maybe report back to us. Or, hey, if you guys got a car for rent, let me know. And I did hear that OIR is going to have some cars available. So that might be a way, you know, fly out there, drop in, even if it's in a Miata. It's a cool way to check out a new track. And on that note, Our friends, Jason and Sarah, over at Auto Interest are also having an extended Black Friday sale. So they'll be running a Black Friday bonus value gift card special. And we've added that link to our show notes. And in addition to that, they're also offering what they call track packs. You can buy the Mid-Ohio 5-event track pack now. It's running $1,199. And you can also pre-purchase the summer camp at Summit Point, which is going to be July 29th through August 1st, 3 tracks over 4 days, Jefferson, Shenandoah, and Summit Point for $745. And those discounts, those track packs, are available until January 28th of 2022. So check out their Black Friday sales, their Fast Pass sales. There's all sorts of other discounts going on. Sign up for Auto Interest's newsletter, go to autointerest.com, and also be sure to check out the episode that we did with Jason Kennedy from Auto Interest earlier this year. Well, you know, looks like we've come to the end of our holiday shopping guide, but I think there's some people that we need to thank. There's some messages that we need to give, some virtual Christmas cards that we need to send.
Sending out virtual thank yous and a big thank you to all of GTM sponsors for supporting us during this very trying year. We look forward to great things in 2022 season. So let's give a big round of applause to
AmericanMuscle.com,
Garage Riot,
HPDEJunkie.com,
Hooked on Driving,
RockAuto.com,
Auto Fab Race Cars,
OG Racing,
Chaz's Used Auto Parts,
Battery Warehouse,
Radial Tire,
Fontana Web Designs,
Harper Home Services of Michigan,
TLCT Motorworks,
RLC Automotive Industries,
Breach Tech Solutions,
Ultimate Outlaws,
and all of our loyal Patreon subscribers. We want to thank each and every one of you for your contributions, your assistance, your sponsorship, your help with making GTM and the Break Fix podcast a success. So if you're thinking, well, how can I be a sponsor or a partner? How do we go about learning about that, Tanya?
Go to our website, visit gtmotorsports.org, and click on Sponsors and Partners under About.
This has been an action-packed year. We have put out 90 episodes in a year and a half. So if you haven't been listening to Break Fix, it's the first time you're tuning in, you have a lot to catch up on. We have had names from all over the motorsports community, you know, from authors to racers to everybody in between. We've done crossover episodes. We've talked tech. We've talked off-roading. We've talked autocross. We've talked racing. I mean, all over the map. We even did a live stream from Road Atlanta at the Petit Le Mans. Some of these episodes are only available currently on Patreon. There's behind the scenes content. I mean, week after week after week. And so I can't thank my co-hosts enough. I'm going to name drop some people that have been on the show multiple times this year. First up, Donovan Laura filling in multiple times for Brad, coming over from the Garage Riot team to help us out. David Andrews from the off-roading group within GTM to come over and be on the show multiple times. He was on the double episode we did with Matt Martelli from the Mint 400 to also talk about Gymkhana. He's done some off-roading stuff. I want to thank David Middleton for coming on multiple times to talk about my racing, and brought over Rob Holland from Rotech Racing. I mean, all these exciting episodes. Tanya, any other folks that you want to thank for being on Break Fix this year?
Mark Shane,
our resident Porsche-phile and petrolhead extraordinaire. He was on our What Should I Buy 90s episode, as well as Drive Through number 14, I think it was.
GTM member Tom Wendy,
region chief extraordinaire and resident Rotard, as he calls himself, our rotary expert, Tom, right? He's also the lead for our virtual racing league, which we hope to be kicking off here in late winter. So stay tuned for details on that. But you know, the list of guests goes on and on. And also, we want to give a huge shout out to Brad. Congratulations to him and Adrian. They had their baby. You know, he's doing his parental duties and all that. We hope to have him back here for our winter special, along with other really cool episodes that we're going to be putting together. We don't want to give away too many spoilers because you guys got enough to catch up on. But if you have ideas for the show, please don't hesitate to reach out. Let us know. Contact us via email, crewchief@gtmotorsports.org, or call or text us at 202-630-1770. And I think there's one last bit of news, a sad farewell we have to get to a guest that has been on the show multiple times.
It's with a heavy heart that we share this news. As many of you probably already aware before the recording of this episode, one of our esteemed members of GTM, Matthew Yip, had been struggling and striving through his battle with kidney failure for many years now. And unfortunately, on November 15th, 2021, he lost that battle. We were all very shocked and saddened by that sudden news. And we hope that wherever he may be now, he is at peace.
That's right, folks. And more details to come on Matthew's celebration of life. So please stay tuned to emails coming from GTMHQ as we reveal more information, as you know, things are kind of playing out and whatnot. So again, it was a shock to all of us that this happened. Matthew's extended family is huge. There's so many people that are coming out and sharing stories. It's hard to get our arms around all this stuff. So he had a major impact in the motorsports community, especially here in the DMV. And so if you're hearing about Matt for the first time, or maybe you knew him on the periphery, we did a special episode this year that aired on his 55th birthday. So you could check out some of his backstory, some of his more famous stories in his own words. The title of that episode is called Y'all Be Yippin'. Big shout out to Matt again, and a thank you, even though he's not here to hear it, for coming on Break Fix and helping us get this show off the ground. He was a big part of season one, and he was on a ton of episodes. So we've linked to that in a time capsule article that's on the GT Motorsports website. So if you search for Y'all Be Yippin', all the information is there. So a big GTM salute to Matthew. You are with us in our thoughts and in our prayers from here on out. And that being said, it's always important to remember something that Brad says over and over again. If he said it once, he said it 100 times. Without members like you and the folks and the family and the friends that support organizations like GTM, none of this would be possible. Oh, and wait, did I forget to thank Tanya again? Our executive co-producer of the Drive Thru.
Of course. Thank you.
And on that note, happy holidays, everybody.
Happy holidays. Don't be throwing decorations at anybody.
Don't!
Well, here we are in the drive-thru line. Me and her. Cars in front of us, cars in back of us, all just waiting to order. There's some idiot in a Volvo with his brights on behind me. I lean out the window and scream, hey, what you trying to do, blind me? My wife says maybe we should park.
If you like what you've heard and want to learn more about GTM, be sure to check us out on www.gtmotorsports.org. You can also find us on Instagram at Grand Touring Motorsports. Also, if you want to get involved or have suggestions for future shows, you can call or text us at 202-630-1770 or send us an email at crewchief@gtmotorsports.org. We'd love to hear from you.
Hey, everybody. Crew Chief Eric here. We really hope you enjoyed this episode of Break Fix, and we wanted to remind you that GTM remains a no annual fees organization, and our goal is to continue to bring you quality episodes like this one at no charge. As a loyal listener, please consider subscribing to our Patreon for bonus and behind-the-scenes content, extra goodies, and GTM swag. For as little as $2.50 a month, you can keep our developers, writers, editors, casters, and other volunteers fed on their strict diet of Fig Newtons, gummy bears, and Monster. Consider signing up for Patreon today at www.patreon.com/GT Motorsports. And remember, without fans, supporters, and members like you, none of this would be possible.